Buhari rejects electoral bill. Hello, my amazing family. At the end of your life, people don't remember your weight, but what you were like as a person. Let your conscience guide you this Yuletide season. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up. If this is your first time, thank you. My family. Now this one that they call Oturugbeke for worry. Ibla say some people not hear the headline way. Make I repeat myself. Buhari rejects electoral bill. As I did, so I not get time to vote up. Make I quickly jump into details to hear what the story get to tell us. President Muhammadu Buhari has returned the Electoral Act Amendment Bill to National Assembly. Sources say the bill was returned to the Senate and the House of Representatives in a letter addressed to the two principal officers from presidency, citing prohibitive cost of conducting direct primaries, which is a provision inserted in the bill by National Assembly in apparent effort to checkmate influence of state governors in primary election processes. President Muhammadu Buhari said Nigerian cannot afford about 500 billion naira the exercise may cost Independent National Electoral Commission INEC. According to the source, President Buhari took the position after he had met with INEC chairman Professor Yakubu Mahmood, who briefed him on the dangers the law posed to the conduct of elections in the coming month, if accepted as passed by NAS. Senate President Ahmed Lawal and Speaker of House of Representatives Femi Gbajagbamila are expected to read the President's letter when the two chambers reconvene next week. It will be recorded that for over 2 weeks, governors elected on the platform of the Ruling All Progressive Congress, APC, and the People's Democratic Party, PDP, had mounted pressure on President Muhammadu Buhari not to sign the Electoral Act Amendment Bill into law until all grey areas were resolved. Many of the governors, who are at loggerheads with senators and members of the House of Representatives from their various states, had insisted that the National Assembly must yank off indirect primaries from the Electoral Act. A report released by Sun newspaper disclosed that President Muhammadu Buhari has rejected the Electoral Amendment Bill because of the removal of indirect primary election from the document. A senator revealed that the bill was returned to the Senate and the House of Representatives in a letter addressed to the two principal officers. However, the source further revealed that President Buhari cited high cost, which hovers around 500 billion naira, of conducting direct primaries by INEC, Independent National Electoral Commission, as the reason for rejecting the amended electoral bill. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first time. Thank you. This decision taken by President Muhammadu Buhari has raised a lot of arguments within the country. It's important to recall that a few weeks ago, a report released by Independent newspaper disclosed that some cabals in APC as supporting the national leader of APC, Bola Ahmed Tinubu, to be the presidential candidate of APC during the coming 2023 general elections. The cabals further claimed that it is the turn of a ACN one of the political parties that formed APC, to produce the next presidential candidate of the APC, and it's important for people to know that Tinubu was the leader of the ACN before they merged with other groups to form APC. Nevertheless, here is how Buhari's rejection of direct primary election may favor the plan of APC cabals to back Tinubu in the coming years for the general election. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. I believe that Buhari's rejection of direct primary election in the amended Electoral Act will favor the APC cabals that are supporting Bola Tinubu. Why, you may ask me? This is because these cabals can easily use their political influence to make Tinubu the presidential candidate of APC or Progressive Congress. It would have been difficult for these APC cabals to make Bola Tinubu the presidential candidate of APC if direct primaries were made compulsory for all political parties. I never hit the nail on the head, but please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up, especially if this is the first time here. Thank you. The first thing we need to know is that people should know that in direct primary election, all the members of a political party are allowed to vote for the candidates or aspirants they want, and this will make it difficult for some individuals to intimidate others with their political influence. My people, we don't hear them that the long-awaited electoral bill, which was worked out by the Nigeria Senate, I mean to say, has been rejected again by our president, Muhammadu Buhari. But as I did talk, so I did see serious chaos coming to the APC camp, because this rejection will collapse the APC as a party, because there was no Congress in all the states of the Federation. All they did was imposition, hence several cases in courts. I'm Market Kobiso, because I know that all the political parties in Nigeria preferred the indirect election rather than direct one. Only general election they will allow to be direct, because they know already they can be cheated by the electorate if they put their choice just in one candidate for the election. Why the general choice of people will be blocked through delegate saga? Make una see sense, so. The Buhari himself became APC candidate in 2019 through direct primary. Is it right to say that his candidacy in 2019 is fraudulent? How about in 2015 primary? How did he emerge? Is it through direct or indirect primary? I tell you one thing, that President Buhari have seen it that the electoral bill will not favor him and his party APC for them to manipulate the results of any electronic votes. That was why he rejected the bill, nothing more. Did other parties complain on the high cost of the process? The answer is capital no, except APC and his leadership. I weep for this nation called Nigeria. I tell you this afternoon that the direct primary is the political calculus of Tinubu. He used it in Lagos State during APC primary against Ambode second term ambition to favor someone law. Now that it has been rejected at the national level, Tinubu may start a rethink of his presidential ambition. But can't NAS use their rights to go ahead with the power given to them to pass the bill without presidential assent? But still, the problem is that if NAS should veto it and sign it into law, how would they implement it when INEC does not have the resources to do it? People at times should drop sentiments and face realities. Please, if you are here for the first time, there is a bell at the right hand. or the left hand, please click on it for more updates. And most importantly, please tell a friend to tell a friend about Fundaways Media. Thanks for staying with us. Bye-bye.